walking into my shed, and this guy just dropped down like this, right in front of me here. Just dropped down from off of there, right in front of my face. And look, watch this. It's about to happen. This wasp is about to take him down. Look at this. Look at this. This wasp is not going to let this spider go. Wow. This spider has huge fangs. Hit him, stung him. Yep, he's stinging him right in the, look at that. Searching, stung him right in the head. Right in the head. Just putting it everywhere, searching for a good spot. Right in the face. Look at that. Man, you do not want to mess with that little guy. Wow. What an efficient killing machine. God. Now this creature, as far as I know, see this insect here that has just basically anesthetized this spider? This creature will then take this spider back to its lair, to this creature's lair, right? And then it will lay larvae, right? Or it already has larvae. Let's see if we can see where he's going. Okay, he's mapping it out. He's mapping out the terrain. So he's gonna drag that spider all the way over there. You saw him go look over there, so let's go see. Somewhere over here is the lair. And the dragging has begun. And that, for you or I, would be maybe like a half a mile. That's a wolf spider. That's what we call a wolf spider. You can see the fangs on that wolf spider. No match for a wasp. Look at those fangs. It's already come quite a way. Look at that. It's already gone about 6 feet. And in total, I would say it's going about, 12 to 14 feet, maybe a little more. I think the wasp is going to do another check. More mapping. you see how that works? He strikes, he anesthetizes his prey, and then maps the area out by flight to know where that prey needs to go exactly. It comes back and retrieves the prey. It's just like if you had gone out into the wilderness and shot a deer, and you were kind of lost and didn't know which way to drag the deer, you'd send up a drone and look for your truck and then walk that direction, wouldn't you? This is interesting. So, okay. Now the funny thing is, the wasp is stuck in an antlion hole. These are called antlions, these little divots in the ground. They're little creatures that live at the bottom of those little volcanoes. And that's how the small bug that walks into those little antlion divots or falls into them gets taken. Those are predators too. But not that big wasp. Looks a little confused. There we go. I think that's the leg. No? I guess the wasp has hidden its lair under the building here, and we won't be able to see it. That's unfortunate.